Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I've been wanting to do this video for quite a while, but I haven't gotten around doing it because, yeah, busy with life and work in general. But yeah, I finally found some time to record this video. I think many people have been asking, and there's also multiple posts on Reddit talking about the differences between farming at the Arcane Force maps as well as the Star Force maps, because recently there has been an update by Nexon to adjust the EXP rates for these specific maps. And yeah, many of us have experimented and decided to try out and see for ourselves which of these maps is actually better for training. And I think the main concern would definitely be from the angle of farming EXP, because yeah, everyone is trying to rush levels and try to hit the 215 mark as soon as possible so that we can start farming the new symbols from Chu Chu Island. Okay, so before I start talking about the stats that I've collated, actually I wanted to first talk about the constants. I think a lot of the stats that we actually see online may not be aligned, and there may be limited adjustments in terms of ensuring that certain variables are consistent. So for a start, I'll be talking about what I have made a constant when I'm recording all these stats. So first of all, I have clocked the stats from four different maps, which is Arcane Force 90, Arcane Force 80, Star Force 184 and Star Force 180. So the current map that you see my character farming at is actually Star Force 180, which is actually the best map for my party. So in terms of the constants when I'm clocking these stats, I stay within the same party of 6 members, which consists of 2 Nightwalkers, 1 Phantom, 2 Bishop and 1 Angelic Buster. So this is my fixed party, and to make sure that the stats that I clock are actually reliable, I ensure that I do not switch parties and we all stay within the same party. So for each of these formats, I actually clocked approximately 1 hour, and it is also with the same hot time EXP of 40%, which is the weekday rate. And we also didn't use any additional EXP buffs except for the EXP that is granted naturally by our equips to make for a more fair kind of comparison. Yeah, so first off, I'll start off by talking about Arcane Force 90. So as you can see on the screen right now, these are the stats that I've clocked over across 4 of my characters. And the stats actually include the timing, the missiles gain, the total EXP gain, as well as the kills. So I have also separately clocked the missiles per minute, EXP per minute, as well as the kills per minute from these stats. And I can conclude that for Arcane Force 90, among the 4 maps, it actually has the best overall missiles gain and the worst EXP gain. So this may not be true for your party, but this is just what I managed to conclude by clocking the stats for 4 of my characters. So in terms of Arcane Force 80, you can see on the screen, so these are the stats that I managed to clock across 4 of my characters. And what I can conclude from this is that Arcane Force 80 actually has the worst missiles gain, and the EXP is on average across my 4 characters, it is actually 24% better than Arcane Force 90. But it is also actually the second worst in terms of EXP gain. So the third map that we experimented at is Star Force 184. And originally, I stopped my experiment here because I kind of assumed that among all the Star Force maps, this Star Force 184 would be the best. But after a while, I noticed that people have been telling me that Star Force 180 is actually better for their party, and I also went to try out in that map for myself. So for Star Force 184, actually it has decent missiles gain, but it is still about on average 8% worse than Arcane Force 90 for my party, and it is 20% better than Arcane Force 20. Arcane Force 80. So there is also a good amount of EXP gain. It is a whopping 84% better than Arcane Force 90 and 49% better than Arcane Force 80. So the final map, as I mentioned earlier, is actually Star Force 180, which actually I also heard by word of mouth. That's why we decided to test out for ourselves over here. And it also has a good missile skin. It is actually even better than Star Force 184. So, but it is still about 5% worse than Arcane Force 90. So you can see on the screen over here, I will place the relative percentage in comparison with the other maps that we have tried at. And of course, the reason why we decided to stay on this map is because it has the best EXP gain among the four maps that we've tried at, and it is 94%, which is almost two times better than Arcane Force 90. It is 56% better than Arcane Force 80, which is about 1.5 times, and it is around 5% better than Star Force 184. I think the only reason why this particular Star Force 180 map is better for my party is because of the two Nightwalkers. So as you can tell, the kills that my Nightwalker has gotten on this particular map is actually significantly higher than all my other characters, mainly because the Nightwalker's hyper actually is a very huge area of effect, and it can instantly kill I think 30 or more mobs at one go, and there's only a 30 seconds cooldown. So this makes this kind of AoE skills and any other class with a large AoE abilities work very very well in this Star Force 180 map. So I do have friends that mentioned to me that Star Force 184 actually provides a higher EXP gain for them. So I think the conclusion is that everyone should definitely test out with your own fixed parties, and just to see which of the maps actually gives you a better EXP gain, because it does not apply for everyone, based on my experience and what I've heard from my friends at least. Yeah, so if you're someone that doesn't have a fixed party and you usually pub, you can also consider just seeing whether the party lineup has many characters with area of effect spells. So most likely if that's the case, you will be able to observe a higher EXP gain. So I think in general that's the guideline that you can consider following. I will also put a summary on the screen right now just for you guys to have a view about the stats that are actually clocked, and it's very hard for us to conclude which of the maps is actually better just by pure observation, because even though the absolute experience gain in the Star Force maps was always better than Arcane Force, but in the past actually Arcane Force 80 map gave me the most EXP gain, and it is mainly because of the number of monsters that spawn and the kill rate. So you can see among all my stats, actually if you just purely observe the kills per minute, Arcane Force 80 has a much higher number compared to the rest of the maps. But even though that's the case, the EXP gain at the Star Force maps is still higher, even with a lower mob spawn and lower kill count. So I really recommend for everyone to just clock your own stats and be more diligent in calculating the missiles and the EXP gain per minute, just to see for yourself. Well, I think that in general, I think Star Force 184 and 180 is definitely better in terms of EXP gain. So my routine now is to go to Star Force 180 map over the weekends when there's additional hot time EXP, and to go back to my cave depths, which is my usual routine on the weekdays, because right now with the changes in the wedding system and the limited number of auto battle tickets, I realized that if I stay in Star Force 180 all the time, I wouldn't be able to farm note stones, which is kind of crucial if I want to progress. And I think right the second V Matrix skill has actually come out, or is going to come out on the Korean server. So I think it's only a matter of months before the new V skill comes out on the global server. So I think it's still quite important to farm note stones before the price surges, because I'm not sure whether Nexon will increase the drop rate to attract more people to farm at the Arcane River maps again. Because from what I observe, most people are kind of farming at the Star Force maps, which makes it very difficult to strike a balance between how much time we want to spend farming for note stones and how much time we want to spend grinding EXP. and especially given that auto battle is so important and limited in supply right now. Yeah, so anyway, I hope you guys find this video helpful. I'm not sure if it helps everyone in particular, since this may only benefit people who actually are farming at the higher Star Force maps or have enough, you know, Star Force to even come to these maps. I didn't experiment for the lower Star Force maps, so do let me know if there's any of these maps that is more preferred for the newer players. And yeah, I might pin your message in the YouTube comments just to help the newer players, because I no longer train at those mats and I haven't been able to clock the stats there. Okay, I hope this video hasn't been too long, but you guys find it helpful. Yeah, so I've come to the end of today's video. Do let me know if you have any views or suggestions and opinions about actually where is the best map for seasoned players to train at. So if you enjoyed my video, please help to like, share and subscribe. I really appreciate all your comments and your likes and your subscriptions. And do press the notification bell button so that you can be notified of my videos whenever they get uploaded on YouTube. Yep, so I hope you enjoy and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!